foremost, I want to thank the mama and papa of this commission for this opportunity. They are giving me to preach this word of God. May the Almighty God continue to uplift them in every part of their life.
Amen.
Today I titled the Sunday school, I Shall Not Be Moved.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Say to yourself, I shall not be moved.
I shall not be moved.
Okay, I'm saying to myself, I shall not be moved.
I shall not be moved.
You see, there are a lot of things in our generation today in our Satan have put into places to push people away.
Yes.
And the most things that you put there are challenges, difficult challenges to push you away from God. Yes. Hallelujah.
Amen.
To draw away from the love of God. And let us to take our memory verse from Psalm 62, verse 2. That is our memory verse. I want us to be somebody to read it for us. We're going to read it together. I shall not be moved. That's our topic today. So I'd like somebody to read the memory verse for us, Psalm 62, verse 2.
I read. Okay. I wanted to speak, but there's no time.
Yeah.
Truly, my soul waited upon God. For me, commend my salvation. Then, two, He holy is my rock and my salvation. Is my defense. I shall not be greatly moved.
Hallelujah. You see, amen. I shall not be what? Greatly moved. It is my word, the faith. If we have this confidence, there are things that will not shake us as Christians.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Because there are a lot of things in this world today that have been put in ground to shake you. As if you are not strong, you will fall out. That's just the plain truth. You will fall out. If the word of God is not there to encourage you, there are times the encouragement of men can even pull you down the wall, can even shake you off. But because of this word of God that you have, that's why I sang that song. The word of God in you is greater than gold and silver.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So it's something that will help you in time of difficulty, in time of challenges. If what you should run to is this word of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's something that will help you for you to what? Come out of that difficulty. It's for you to help you to come out of that challenges. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And when you are being faced with all problem, the best thing to do is for you to what? Run to the word of God.
Yes.
And that goes to go to the book of Psalm 125, verse 1. Psalm 125, verse 1.
I read.
Yes.
They that trust in the Lord shall be as Mount Zion, which cannot be moved.
Are you getting it? These are that scripture again. When you trust in the Lord, he said, where did you put your trust? Where are your trust? Did you put your trust in chariots? Did you put your trust in the government? Did you put your trust in friends? Did you put your trust in family? All those things we can fail you. But you see, when you put your trust in God, you can never
be moved.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You can never be shaped away. Are you getting it?
Yes.
So some devil can come and make you to lose your son or your daughter, but you will stand to say, I still stand for this God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Some devil can come and make you look as if you have no money to spend anymore. No money for you to even transport to church. You are still trekking on your way coming to the church. You say, I'm not going to move. God is watching you.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Men cannot reward you. But this God that you trust will reward you. That is saying, one with God is the majority. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So it doesn't matter those you look at. You are in a battlefield. You look, there's nobody behind you. But who stands with you is your God.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's your God that stands with you. So you cannot be moved. That is what I came to put in your heart today. The government have said you should leave the country. You say, God, I don't know where I'm going to. I shall not be moved for your life strength. When you confess this confession to yourself, you see that boldness in you because he has given you the trust. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You begin to see yourself. You went to the doctor. The doctor said, your fallopian tube is blocked. You say, I shall not be moved. He will not delay you from coming to church. He will not stop you because the word of God is your strength.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
you shall not be
moved.
When you trust in God, you have its divine stability. You become stable. But when you put your trust in man, and you are calling, my friend, where are you now? I'm in the trailer, I'm in the bus. You will not even see him. You become so disappointed. But when you put your trust in God, you say, God, you said in your word, in Psalm 125, you say, my trust is in you. And they that put their trust in you shall not be moved. Are you getting it?
Yes.
So with that, you have that confidence to move in any situation. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You have been called for an interview. You have been called for court. You have been called in anywhere. But when you get to the place, the first mentality matters a lot, that you are not alone. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And you cannot be moved. Circumstances will not move you.
Amen.
I don't know the kind of problem I want to mention right now that can want to move some Christians away from God. Because one thing you say, I will not come to church. I will not go to church anymore. Because this problem is hard for me. Somebody may not cause a problem for you. You may abuse your hand to cause a problem for yourself. But because you may not be getting a solution, you will say, I want to leave. I want to do this. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But you have forgotten that the Bible says, when your trust is in me, you cannot be moved. Hallelujah.
Amen.
There is one somebody that God so values so much. He said that I've never seen a king like this in Judah. That king's name was King Hezekiah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
King Hezekiah was so strong. He said because he was having a threat from Syria, the king of Syria. He threatened him so much. Tell him, you are this, I'm going to finish you. You are nothing. I don't know who have threatened your life. I don't know the prophet that have threatened you. I don't know the dirty doctor that have told you that I have your pens, I have your materials with you, I'm going to destroy you. It doesn't matter the person that have told you that. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But what matters is that what God have said, that you cannot be moved. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I have to read some things about this Hezekiah. Let's go to the book of 2 Kings 18. 2 Kings 18. Second King 18, 5 to 7. 18, 5 to 7.
He trusted in the Lord God of Israel.
Okay, you come down. He did what? He trusted in the Lord God of Israel.
So that after him was no like him among all the kings in the land, nor any of them before.
Yeah. Amen. You see, there were no other kings like him or him after him. Well, because why? He trusted in the God.
Yeah.
I don't see the difficulties in life that more than you trusting in God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When Elisha was in a battlefield with his servant, his servant told him, he said, these people, they are so much. We can't defeat these people. But he said, because God has not opened your eye to see that the one that are with us are more than those that are with them. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because that is, you know your God. Are you getting it? And when the one that tell you to know your God is not from your mouth, you know it from the word of God. You know it through the word of God. You study. You can get it through me. Then you go out. The Bible says, study to show yourself approved. You go home, you also need to study it. Spend time with him. Spend time to communicate with him, because he's there to communicate with you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He's there to make you, he's there to put you through. He's there to make sure to understand that you get what you are saying. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And because of this, you cannot be moved. I don't know how tough the situation is. Don't think that, don't be so discouraged that I'm a Christian. I serve my God. I'm always in church. I'm always in praying group. I'm always in fasting. I'm always worshiping God. I'm always singing. I'm always preaching. I'm always evangelizing. But why is it happening to me? It's happening to you because God wants to let you know that he cannot be moved.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Because you stand for him. If you trust, I'm going to put you in your hand and you need to what? Trust in him. Because you see sometimes, when you see some unbeliever operating on faith, I will imagine how are this kind of unbeliever operating more than some believers. That you are in church. There are things that cannot scare you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's not because you are trying to be arrogant or you are trying to be trying to misbehave at all, but you are trying to operate your faith in God, which gives you His word, because it's with you. You have the confidence in God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Because at that time, you need to understand that those that are planning things, those that have told you, if you see what the king of Syria, Assyria, was saying to Hezekiah, he was telling, I'm going to fight with my men, with my thousands of soldiers. I will finish all of you. I will finish all of you because of what I have. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But on the day, what they have failing, because the God that Hezekiah put on was a great God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's like David also wanted to confront Goliath. He came with him. He said, you are a giant, but my trust is in God. I cannot be what?
Be moved.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I want to tell you some things that I study so much about Hezekiah. The first thing I noticed about him, he cleaved to God. Even that despite the threatening, despite the threatening he received, he cleaved himself to God. Another thing I studied, he did not backslide. He refused to backslide. Despite the threatening, he refused to backslide. There are many times that I was telling somebody, I said that, do you know that the enemy will want you to backslide so that you miss your blessing?
Yes.
He will want you, he will try as all means. And when he comes with a strong delusion to make it real. I get it. Don't have this in his wife. When the enemy can bring it to you, he can bring it to you to black. You will even look at it. I see black. But it's not black.
It's white.
It's white. Because he has bring everything to confuse you, to tell you why you should not serve God, why you should not worship God. And me and you know, is this God that created your life? Is this God that make us live today, to see today? I'm not better than people that have died. Or neither am I better than people that died in the sea or in the desert. But God kept me alive for His purpose. And I still keep that purpose, and I keep to say, I trust in this God, I can never be moved. Situation will not move me away from God. Problem will not move me away from God. That's what He's trying to tell you, that put that trust in God. It's not in me. I can fail you. Standing before you, I can fail you. Are you getting it? But God can't fail you. He's a big God. He's a large God. It doesn't matter how it doesn't matter how strong the problem is. It's just it's one watching you to see if you will run out of His presence and say, I will no longer depend on this God anymore. That is what is waiting for you. But when you rely and say, no, God, I am not going back from your way, then you will see the way He bless you. That is the way He fought for Hezekiah. Hallelujah. He refused to backslide. Another thing I studied about him, he kept the commandment of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He kept the commandment of God. God has given you more. Worship me. He said, if you refuse to worship me, I will rise up stones that will worship me. I said, God forbid. No. He's not in my time, God. I will worship you to the end of my life.
Amen.
It's a choice.
Yes.
That's why we are going out to tell people, you must follow the gospel. Because God has given us what? His commandments.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Another thing I looked about the blessings. Why God bless him? God was with him always. When he kept all these promises, God was with him. God prospered him. In the battle, he won the battle. He came out victorious in the battle.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you,
Lord. Another thing again, God will give you peace. And when He is telling you that you cannot be moved, after the trials, after the tribulation, He will give you peace.
Amen.
Let's go to the book of Psalm 26, verse 3. Psalm 26, verse 3.
Verse 3, I read. Say, for thy loving kindness is before my eyes.
Yes.
And I have walked in thy truth.
Yes.
Then verse 4.
Verse 4.
I have not sat with vain persons.
Yes.
Neither will I go in with deceivers.
Yes.
Verse 5. Yes. I have entered the completion of evil doers.
Yes.
And I will not sit with the wicked.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You see, well, that was what God said. He give you what? Peace. I will not allow you to sit with what? The wicked. Amen. Amen. God is going to do something that will that will shock you. But if you only do it, something that will shock you, if only you will trust in Him. If only, that's why I came to put in your mind. Only if you could what? Trust in this God. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. I want us to go to the book of Isaiah 50 verse 7. That is what I will be rounding up with. Isaiah 50 verse 7. Isaiah 50 verse 7. Yeah.
For the Lord God will help me, therefore shall I not be confounded. Therefore have I set my face like a flint, and I know that I shall not be ashamed.
And let us to open that verse. Everybody should read it together. Who will help you? Is it me? Is it said the end will help you? Is that what's written there?
No.
He said the Lord God will help you. It's not me, or it's not even the government. What I'm just there for you is to what? Tell you the word.
Yes.
As the mama, papa, ministers all the day to tell you the word that will keep you strong, that will not make you shake when you see difficulties. That's why the word is coming to you.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Who is doing it? It's God.
God.
It's not them. It's not me. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I want us to read that part again. Open that back, open the book there. Isaiah 50 verse 7.
Everybody open your Bible.
Open your Bible. Everybody should open your Bible. Isaiah 50 verse 7.
Verse 7.
Isaiah 50 verse 7.
Verse 7.
Everybody.
Isaiah 50 verse 7.
Verse 7.
That is what He will do for us.
We need the Bible. Don't see who have the Bible.
Open your Bible, please. Isaiah 50, verse 7.
Yes, you are there. Stand up.
Let's confess it. Let's say confession. Is a confession?
Sit down.
What of God said? It is
7.
Yeah?
Read it. Are we all there?
Yes.
Okay. He said what?
For the Lord God will help me, therefore shall I not be confounded. Therefore have I set my face like a flint, and I know that I shall not be ashamed.
Therefore will I not be confounded. That confounded means that there will not be, as in, moved.
Yes.
Problem or the challenges. There will never be confounded. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I want you to confess that part again. Put your name there. Put your name there. That means your name.
Yes.
Put your name there.
Amen.
Put your name there as you confess it together.
Amen.
For the Lord
will help me, Nathaniel. Therefore, Nathaniel shall not be confounded. Therefore, I have not set my face like a flint, and I know that I shall not be ashamed.
We should be genuine with our God.
Yes.
We can never be ashamed.
Amen.
Never. We can never be put to shame. Because He sees the heart. Hallelujah.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.
Before we wrap up, I don't know, is there any question you want to ask? Is there anything that you want to contribute to what we have said in this Sunday school this morning? Because it's a Sunday school. It's where we have to come to learn. It's a learning. But if there is no question, I can point somebody to give me an answer to my question. I know everybody might be not saying, this brother should not go and point to you. Where is even looking at me now? In my mind, it's me. Because I want to point somebody to give me an answer to a question. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 First of all, we're going to warm here. No, this is not mommy. This is not mommy. Okay, let me think. I want to know before. It's a simple question. I want to know what is our Sunday school topic today. Just that one.
The topic is, I shall not be
mad. Let's clap for her.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Is
Is there any contribution?
No.
Is there any contribution that you want to talk about? Hallelujah.
Amen.
If there's no contribution, my question now is to the house. So I don't quote anybody. When you are faced with diverse situation, with serious problems, and even everybody has given up on you, what should you do? What do you think you could do?
Cry to God.
I don't need chorus answer. Larry.
One
sister hand was there. Mommy, we still care to you. Give us what she does.
No.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Isaiah 41, verse 10, when you read it now, he said, I will be your helper, be not dismayed. Wherever thing that goes, whatever thing that we are passing through, that God must surely help us.
Amen.
Amen. Let's pray for that. I don't know what to do. Let's pray for that. Because this is when you answer the question, you quote scripture. Scripture is good.
Yes.
He helps you. Even though you cannot just read it, you can use your, there's a phone that has to, you can just. Download this thing in your phone, it gives you verses. If you don't have to just press the play, you start reading the verse for you. It helps you in times of any difficulty. Your scriptures is there for you. You say, Lord, in your word, in Isaiah, this, you said this, in Matthew, this, you said this. Lord, don't forsake me, I'm all alone like this. You see what God can do. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Is there a contribution for going to? We have three
prayers. I want to also admit to you.
Okay.
If you go to Isaiah 43, verse 2. The Bible says, when thou go through water, I will be with you. Can you hear me?
Yes,
when thou go through the river, the sea, you will not be drowned. Can you hear what I'm saying?
Yes.
And when you go through fire, you shall not be burned, or neither the fire will kindle against you. Kindle. The flame will not touch you. It means no matter how tough is the trouble, when you believe in God, He will be with you and will bring you out of that trouble.
Yes.
May God help us in Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Let's clap our hands. We also have said it all. We should all learn to trust in our God in time of problem, in time everybody has thrown their back, your best friend, your husband, your wife, everybody has thrown up. The person to run to is the word of God.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. Let's stand on our feet as we say this three prayer point. I like to pray it then with all seriousness. Even though you crack your words, you have got a good answer. You have made a good bargain. So I like you to pray with all seriousness.
I vomit every food of sin in my life.
I vomit every food of sin in my life.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
I vomit it in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Oh Lord, forgive me
for bringing problems into my life.
In the name of Jesus.
Lord, forgive me. Forgive all my sins for bringing problems into my life. Lord Jesus, forgive me for bringing problems into my life. Forgive me, Lord. Forgive me. Lord Jesus, forgive me. Forgive me, Jesus. In the name of Jesus.
Amen. You know that there's no off problem that is caused by any issues. At all. There's no problem that is caused by witchcraft.
At all.
But there's problem that use your hand
to cause.
Amen. You are the one that brought to yourself. So when you pray God to forgive you, God can take it.
Yes.
I want you to share this prayer.
Oh Lord,
forgive me all the problems I bring into my life.
In the name of Jesus. Lord, forgive me all my sins. All the problems that I bring into my life, Lord, forgive me. Jesus, forgive me. Jesus, forgive me. Forgive me all the problems that have caused to my life, all the sins that have caused to my life. Jesus, forgive me. All the trouble that have caused to my life. Jesus, forgive me. I'm sinner. I pray for sinners and abomination for you, Lord, have mercy. Forgive me all my sins, oh God. Forgive me. Lord, forgive me. Lord, forgive me. Lord Jesus, forgive me. Lord Jesus, forgive me. Lord, in any area that I've sinned against you, anywhere, any manner of my sin, knowing or unknowing it, forgive me, Lord. Forgive me, Jesus. Lord, forgive me my sin. Oh, Lord, forgive me. Jesus, forgive me. Jesus, forgive me. Jesus, forgive me my sin. 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 Forgive me my sin in the name of Jesus. Amen. Prosperity is mine. I am worthy, Jesus. I am worthy, Lord. I am worthy living in this world. Empower me to prosper. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Yes, Lord.
Let your word grow in our life.
Yes, Lord.
And germinate.
Yes.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Put your hands together for Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Amen.
We should have prayer put to just say the best thing to repeat the prayer to make accessory. Amen. Oh Lord, forgive me for my problem. I use my heart to cause. It cannot be like, amen.
Amen.
Stop it during message. Stop it.
Okay.
Amen.